Welcome to this brief guide on how to add a watermark in Microsoft Word. Now you're in Microsoft Word and you've finished typing up that important letter or that draft document and you want to finalize it with a nice watermark? Well, today I'm going to show you how to do that in Microsoft Word. Here I have my important letter and I want to tag this with an important watermark. I could look at utilizing the search menu and just searching for watermark to find the option, but if you'd prefer to find it in your ribbon itself, you can head over to the Design tab. Selecting the Design tab will let us then go all the way over to the right-hand side, and in the Page Background section, we can find the option for watermark. Selecting the drop-down menu there will give us a selection of pre-made watermarks that we can choose from, ranging from confidential, do not copy, draft, all the way through to ones such as ASAP and Urgent. Selecting any of these will automatically apply that watermark to your document. But what if you wanted to have something that didn't quite match up to any of those particular ones? Well, in the watermark category, we can head all the way down to the bottom and there's an option available for us that says Custom Watermark. Selecting this will give us a pop-up in the middle of our screen where we can choose from either a picture watermark or a text watermark. In the text watermark option, we can actually type into the text field exactly what it is we would like our watermark to say. We can also use drop-down menus to change the font. So for instance, we can choose to match a particular font if we have one for our business. In this case, I'm just going to use the option for Chiller. And then I can also use the color options and change the color of the watermark as per my needs. I can then even choose whether or not the watermark is semi-transparent or not, and then whether or not it is diagonal or horizontal across my document. Once I'm ready, I select Apply and click Close, and there is my red important diagonal watermark in the Chiller font. If I wanted to remove that though, if I've made a mistake, in the watermark category, I can simply choose the option that says Remove Watermark. And now we'll go through the other option in the Custom Watermark section as well, which is the option for a picture watermark. Selecting Picture Watermark will give us a couple of options to select from, the first of which is to use the Select Picture option, which will let us choose to either search for our particular image on Bing, browse one of our cloud storage services, or even choose to browse our own local file explorer. And here I'll select the Microsoft 365 logo that I have. Please try and use a transparent layered image if you can, as they will work best. And then you have the option as to whether or not you want your image to be slightly washed out or not. I'm going to select that and then select OK. And now my picture watermark is applied directly to my document. And that is how you create and customize a watermark in Microsoft Word. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it saves you plenty of time in the future. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.